There's nothing to do on this campus. UMBC doesn't have a college town, it's a commuter school. Have you ever had these feelings about UMBC? If so, then this is where you should be. My name is Mershad Devon, and I'm on a journey to make Arbutus our college town. Hey guys, how are you guys doing today? So today's special guest is Maria Vicente, one of my close friends. And yeah, we're just gonna go to Arbutus, get some food, maybe explore around a little bit, see what's up. But besides that, nothing else. I just wanna, you know, remind you guys again that this whole project is to bring the student body, you guys, out to Arbutus. If you don't mind answering, so what is your class standing?
So I am a sophomore and I am a GES major, which is Geography and Environmental Science. Mm-hmm. I live on campus. I live in Erickson. And what else?
Alrighty. So the second question that I have for you, you know, since you're a sophomore, you were a freshman last year, right? Mm-hmm. That's how it usually works.
Usually, yes.
So as an incoming freshman, how did you like UMBC?
I actually liked that it was a little more quiet than most schools because it gave me a lot of time to focus on like my classes and stuff. And you know, I feel like if you can make like anything fun if you have the right people. And like I made some really good friends.
Yeah.
You included. And so it was a lot of fun for me at least. But yeah.
Yeah. The thing about, you know, UMBC is that like there's a lot to do, right? You know, whenever people say there's nothing to do on this campus, you know, it's just that like you haven't looked hard enough. You know, every day SCB, a partner organization of SGA, is putting on thousands and thousands and thousands of events per semester just for the student body, just for you guys to go out and enjoy. And you just gotta look, right? You just gotta look. And not just on campus, off campus there's also a lot of places. What are your favorite places to go off campus if you go off campus?
Well, now this place is the 76. And then I really like Tasty. They have the lychee blossom.
Transportation to anywhere?
A couple times to the Inner Harbor last year, which is also just a really good place, and it's nice not to pay for parking because it's always so expensive there.
Okay, listen, freshman, I'm gonna tell you this. Or sophomores, honestly, because I know people who haven't been to Inner Harbor yet. If you guys haven't been to Inner Harbor yet, you guys are missing out. Listen, it's 20 minutes away from campus with transportation, public transportation. You know, we have transit, UMBC Transit takes you there and back. All the information for the lines are online. I think it's also on UMBC SGA website,
but
if not, it's free. Everything is free.
Like, an Uber there will cost you at least $20.
$20, right? And, you know, this is service that UMBC provides for the UMBC students, so go ahead and grab that because it's so pretty. Literally, like,
really, really nice.
And their food. Maria D's restaurant,
so
that's the best
good.
Place I've ever
also
been to.
Strawberries by.
Oh my god, okay, so we're going to Inner Harbor one day. I'm gonna take you guys to Inner Harbor one day, and you guys will find out. If there's any final comments that you want, anything you want to say to the incoming freshman class, or freshman class that's already here, or honestly, any UMBC student, in terms of involvement on campus or like stuff to do off campus.
I'd say just like show up to more events because they're really fun, but it's more fun when there's more people there than not. You know, like there was like 10 people at the bonfire, that would have been boring, but there was a lot of people there and it was really nice.
I think I also want to echo that there's a lot of stuff you just gotta be there.
Yeah.
We just gotta take that opportunity to be there. A lot of these stuff you can find on my UMBC, and if you're part of an organization or a club and you're included on their emails list, you know, they'll also email you if they have events and all that. Anyways, thank you guys so much for coming with us and, you know, staying tuned this long. I try to make these as entertaining as possible for you guys. I'm going to bring a different student of a different background every week, so we have a lot of diversity and inclusion of everyone, because UMBC is a diverse, as a super diverse school, right? So we're going to include everyone, and if you guys are interested in being in one of these videos, please, please, please hit me up. I'm linking my information down below. I'm also linking this girl's information down below, so please go ahead and hit us up. But besides that, thank you guys.
This is probably the best food I've ever had in my life. Okay, the best burger I've ever had in my life. I'm not slicing it, it's really good. And it's only $5.50 if you're a UMBC student.
The pizza's really good.
You get a large fries as well. Fountain soda.
The pizza's really good.
Yeah. So come on down. It's really close to campus as well. So, you know, it's a 20-minute walk, but it's worth it. Trust me, it's worth it. I don't know what the hours are, but it's probably going to be on the SGA website soon. But yeah, keep a lookout for that.
We're almost finished. Finished this part.
Well, that was sliced in.
So much food, and I can't even handle how much food it was.
It's really good.
And so cheap as well. Like, literally, look, I got this whole thing of fries left. I'm about to get away because I can't finish this. But, would you recommend our viewers to go out and take this?
10 out of 10. Really good.
10 out of 10, guys. 100%. And this is just one of many, many places around campus that has really, really good food. We're gonna explore options later on in the process. But for now, Pizza 76. Like from us. Alright, since today is the first episode, we're just gonna give you a gist of whatever is, you know, in Arbutus. There's a lot of stuff, right? So there's a mini mart. I do all of my, shopping for, like, my essentials over there, because Rite Aid is there, but Rite Aid is expensive. This mini mart is cheap. And it's like a gas station, so that I get all my gas over there. It's like 5 minutes away from campus.
Gas is pretty cheap here, too.
Gas is really cheap from here. There's a carpet service over there. If you guys mess up your carpets and don't want to be charged by Red Life, that's something that you can do. But, there's a music store over there. It's called Now and Then Music. I'm pretty sure they do 10% off, too. But I'm not sure. See, there's a lot of stuff. There's like so many stores back to back to back to back. We just gotta keep walking. And that's my favorite cafe ever. Oak Creek Cafe. This place is amazing because I just come here and study all the time, and it's so close to campus. You know, if I'm tired of waiting in library, it's just like, you know, in a stinky RLC, just come here and just hang out here. Oh yeah, Cactus Silvestre is also really good. They do Taco Tuesdays. I think it's a dollar taco. What is it?
Yeah,
it's a dollar per taco. And perfect. Oh yeah, Sorrento. So Sorrento's, Sorrento's also takes your
flex.
Yeah, so it takes flex money. They do Universal Comics, that's 10% off. Oh yeah. And then Tasty. Okay, let's be honest. Who doesn't love Tasty? Yeah, Tasty. Oh, and a yoga studio here. Yoga studio here.
Yeah, I've done yoga there. It's a lot of fun.
Yeah. Also, if you guys didn't know, yoga does rack. The rack. Oh, so yoga does rack.
The rack does yoga.
The rack does yoga every day at 7. 7 a.m.
Also great classes.
Great classes. I've been. Maria has been. It's really nice. But yeah, that's basically. Yeah, but anyways. Oh yeah, another pawn shop. Wow, there's so many pawn shops here. What the heck?
I love Osmond
Sound. Oh.
It's a cute little store.
another episode maybe.
Yep.
Yep.
And they have a company like this in Canesville too.
Yeah, Canesville. Okay, so we'll do a little bit of exploration in Canesville as well. Canesville has a lot more than Arbutus, but Arbutus is our official college town, right? Because it's so close to us. Oh yeah, Haircutting Zone. That's my place, bro. Listen, Haircutting Zone does $12 haircuts on Thursdays, and that's a steal. Maria, let's go cut our hair over there. Oh, well, that's it for today, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this little adventure with me and Maria Vicente. I am gonna. Yeah, you're welcome. Thank you for coming. I'm gonna plug her information down below. Go follow her on Instagram or whatever else she decides to give out. And stay tuned for next week's. It's gonna be a fun one. Hopefully, we're gonna get some bubble tea, visit some stores, maybe a pawn shop or two. So stay tuned. All right, bye.